last week, you and I talked a little bit about the foolishness of self-centeredness. It came from a devotional that Paul David Tripp wrote, and today we want to look at another one of those foolish ways in which we act and in which we live. We're going to call that one the foolishness of self-deception. Let's go over the hump. Paul David Tripp wrote recently in one of his devotionals about four stages of foolishness, and last week we talked about the foolishness of self-centeredness. Now today I want to talk about the foolishness of self-deception. As I said in the beginning, Paul David Tripp says that we are incredibly gifted self-swindlers. What do we mean by that? Well, there was a time in my life where I convinced myself that I needed that drink. I needed that alcohol to settle my nerves, or I needed that alcohol just to chill out for a little while, or I needed that alcohol to have a good time. There was a time that I was foolish and convinced myself that pornography was just a good marital aid. There have been so many ways in which I have self-deceived myself, but I see it all around me. I see women who believe that they are not worth anything better than these abusive relationships that they continue to find themselves in. I see those who believe that, like I did for a long time, that comfort food would actually comfort me. And I've added on plenty to show my track record in regard to that own self-deception. I see men who think that the only way to settle anything is with a fist. I see teenagers who believe that the only way to feel and to sense love is to get intimate with another person, that's the only way to discover what love is. I hear those who cohabitate and live together saying, you know, this is the way that we prepare for marriage. We are incredibly gifted at self-deceiving. But Jesus said these things. He said, you're going to know the truth, and the truth is going to set you free. But what is truth? It's the question that Pilate asked of Jesus when Jesus was in his courtroom just before the crucifixion. Pilate said, well, what is truth? Well, one thing is, we have been given the truth in God's word. We have been given his word to discover truth and to live our lives by it. We've been indwelt as believers by the Holy Spirit to help us to understand, to bring conviction upon our lives when we are self-deceiving ourselves. You know, I think about what Peter said in the two letters that he wrote, because he talked about holy living. He talked about living for Christ. But certainly Peter had deceived himself in his lifetime again and again. Remember how he deceived himself into believing that nothing bad was going to help was going to come to Jesus, because he was going to, by his own might and by his own power, prevent that very thing. Think about when he was foolish and he stood out on the water and he got his eyes off of Jesus. He deceived himself, perhaps in his mind, thinking, look what I did. We deceive ourselves all the time. I'm certain for Peter that throughout his life, throughout his ministry, throughout his teaching and his preaching, he couldn't help but reflect back on that day that he said, I will never, never deny you. And yet he did, not once, not twice, but three times. But I also know that Peter heard truth from Jesus later. And even though he reflected and probably once again felt bad for what he had done, he also had an opportunity to reflect when Jesus said, Peter, do you love me? Feed my sheep. Not once, not twice, but three times, so that Peter would know it wasn't about Peter's love for Jesus. It was about Jesus' love for Peter and his plan for Peter's life. The same is true for you. I think part of those thoughts led Peter to write these words that I just remind you of. If you're a believer, a follower, a disciple of Jesus Christ, then you have been declared a chosen people. Not that we chose Jesus, but that he chose us. He goes on to say in 1 Peter chapter 2 that we are a royal priesthood, that every believer in Christ is in the priesthood. Why? Because we've been indwelt by the Holy Spirit, the entire power and wisdom of God. He says you are a holy nation. That reminds us we're not alone in this. We are a part of a kingdom that has been set apart. Let me ask you this today. Will you continue to live your life out in the deceptions of those things that you have continued to compromise in? Perhaps it's things you know are the truth of God's word, but yet you have said, I'm choosing my way because it brings me pleasure, or it fulfills a need in my life. Know the truth, Jesus said, and the truth is going to set you free. You are part of the beloved. You are a part of this holy nation. You are a royal priesthood. You are a chosen people. And then Peter said, you are a people. You are a person belonging to God. Your life is not your own. You were bought with a great and a high price. Where are you deceiving yourself in your life today? Would you let God examine you? Would you let the Holy Spirit look through those things in your life? And then let me pray that you and I, as we do that, will have the courage to say no to the thing that we've compromised on and yes to Jesus. Let's pray. Father, we love you. We thank you for your great mercy, your grace. God, we thank you for your forgiveness. We thank you that God, when we have deceived ourselves, you're still there. You never give up. He who began a good work in us, you, God, you're going to complete that work. But God, help us to have the courage when we identify those things in our life. And God, I know a lot of people watching this are no different than me in that we already know what we're thinking of in that regard. Lord, give us the love that we need to have for you in order to have the power to say no to that deception, that lie, the one that comes from the Father of all lies. Say no to that lie and say yes to you. We thank you that you are faithful, and that God, that when we are willing to surrender and let you be the Lord of our life, the master over us, then that God, you will guide those steps. We give you praise, we give you honor, we give you glory. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Now to our Freedom Church family, I say looking forward to seeing some of you all on Wednesday night as our life groups gather. We have other life groups that meet during the week. Get plugged into one of those life groups. Sunday morning, we'll continue in our series, Renovatus, the Latin word for renovating our life. This coming Sunday, we are going to look at the relationship choice. Man, if you've struggled with relationships in your life and you want to put some things right, or you have a friend who's struggling right now with a relationship and you want to give them some godly counsel, some godly advice, join us this Sunday morning at 9:30 for our Sunday celebration. God bless you. Have a great rest of the week.